holds the House.
Mm-hmm.
Megan.
Trace, thank you. Joining us now with more, Newt Gingrich. He served as Speaker of the House. He's a Trump supporter and author of the book Treason. Great to see you, Mr. Speaker. Thanks for being here. So
it's good to be back.
I mean, with Cook and many other nonpartisan independent pollsters now saying that the Senate is likely lost to the Republicans, what does that say? I mean, if Donald Trump loses this White House race and the Republicans lose the Senate, does that suggest that the Republicans nominated the wrong candidate at the top of their ticket?
The next 2 weeks are a contest of two parallel universes. I just listened to that report. First of all, I used to hang out with Charlie Cook when he would explain that Donald Trump was hopeless and would not get the nomination. I like Charlie. That doesn't mean he's infallible. But let's take the report we just got. Republicans are actually outvoting Democrats in Florida. They're outvoting Democrats in Pennsylvania. That's unprecedented. They've cut the Democratic lead.
You predict a win in Pennsylvania?
I think they might.
Really? Do you think Trump's going to win Pennsylvania?
Look, all I can report to you right now is they're outvoting the Democrats in early voting, which is also true in Florida, which is unprecedented.
But all of the polls in Pennsylvania have her winning.
What?
All of the polls in Pennsylvania have her ahead.
I know. I just told you we have two alternative universes right now. In Iowa, for example, the Democrats are 50,000 votes behind where they were with Barack Obama in turnout. The governor is very confident we're going to carry Iowa, which Obama carried last time. I could just carry you through case after case like this. In Minnesota, we're almost certainly going to win the congressional seat up around Duluth, which is a very Democratic area, but it deeply dislikes Hillary Clinton. And represent now.
But let me just ask you, because you say it's two alternate universes. I mean, these are sort of small examples of how he might be heading early voting and so on. But I'm telling you that the Fox News decision desk just moved Iowa, that you just mentioned, Indiana, second congressional district in Maine. All of them moved left, moved more likely to vote for Hillary Clinton. And in fact, all of the moves that have been on this map over the past 3 weeks by Larry Sabato, by Cook, by the Fox News decision desks, these are nonpartisan outlets that are just trying to call the electoral scoreboard.
They're not nonpartisan outlets. Every outlet you described is part of the establishment.
Fox News, really? Are we? I don't think so.
And
every state they've moved, they've moved it to the left, towards Hillary. And you tell me whether that's all made up.
No, I think they're two alternative universes. You have a poll which suggests that she's going to get a Barack Obama turnout among African Americans. I don't think that's going to happen. You have a Washington Post ABC News poll where they took out 8% of the vote because they didn't like the way it voted. Look, I've been around long enough. I remember when the Detroit Liberal newspaper on the Sunday before the election said John Engler would lose by 14 points. He won the governorship that year. Mm-hmm. I don't take polls as seriously as people who've never run for office.
But your candidate loves them and has touted them from the beginning. And he's been behind in virtually every one out of the last 40 polls that we've seen over the past month. That's the reality.
Look, if you want to assume the election's over, skip the next 2 weeks and we can talk about the future.
I'm not assuming anything. I'm asking you whether you believe your candidate's behind based on these numbers and what it says about the down ballot races.
I believe the odds are at least 1 in 3 and maybe better than that. That the difference in intensity and the difference in determination and the degree to which Hillary Clinton is clearly the most corrupt, dishonest person ever nominated by a party all mean that the odds are pretty good she's not going to win. Mm-hmm. Now, I actually believe that. This is not just because I'm for Donald Trump. I actually believe the American people
are sickened
by this.
So let's assume she is corrupt, right? She was as corrupt 3 weeks ago and 3 months ago, and she would have been corrupt and collapsing physically on September 11th of this year, and her poll numbers tanked. But then you know what happened. He had a rough first debate. He took the bait on Alicia Machado. He stayed in that trap for a week. The Access Hollywood tape came out, which was not produced by Hillary Clinton. That was Trump on camera talking about grabbing women.
Look, I just heard you go through this with Governor Pence. I get it. I know where you're coming from. But let me point out something to you.
Sure.
The three major networks spent 23 minutes attacking Donald Trump that night and 57 seconds on Hillary Clinton's secret speeches. You don't think this is a scale of bias worthy of Pravda and Izvestia? I mean, you want to know why Donald Trump's had a rough time?
If Trump is a sexual predator, that is...
He's not a sexual predator.
Okay,
you
that's
can't
your
say
opinion.
That.
I'm
you
not taking
not
a position
defend
on
that
it.
Statement.
I am not taking a position on it.
I'm sick and tired of people like you using language that's inflammatory, that's not true.
Excuse me, Mr. Speaker.
Donald Trump has no idea
whether it's true or not. What we know is that
neither do you.
That's right, and I'm not taking a position on it, unlike
you. Yes, you are.
You.
When you use the words, you took a position.
So what
I think
I said
it's very unfair of you to do that, Megan.
Incorrect.
I think that is exactly the bias people are upset by.
I think that your defensiveness on this may speak volumes, sir.
No,
what I said
let me just
is
suggest
if,
to you.
No, no, no. Let me make my point, and then I'll give you the floor. What I said is if Trump is a sexual predator, then it's a big story. And what we saw on that tape was Trump himself saying that he likes to grab women by the genitals and kiss them against their will. That's what we saw. Then we saw 10 women come forward after he denied actually doing it at a debate to say that was untrue. He did it to me. He did it to me. We saw reporters. We saw people who had worked with him, people from Apprentice and so on and so forth. He denies it all, which is his right. We don't know what the truth is. My point to you is, as a media story, we don't get to say the 10 women are lying. We have to cover that story, sir.
Sure. Okay, so it's worth 23 minutes of the three networks to cover that story. And Hillary Clinton in a secret speech in Brazil to a bank that pays her $225,000, saying her dream is an open border where 600 million people could come to America. That's not worth covering.
That is worth covering.
When you want to go back through the tapes of your show recently, you are fascinated with sex and you don't care about public policy.
Me?
Now, that's
really
what I get out of watching you tonight.
You know what, Mr. Speaker? I'm not fascinated by sex, but I am fascinated by the protection of women and understanding what we're getting in the Oval Office. And I think the American voters would like to know.
And therefore, we're going to send Bill Clinton back to the East Wing because, after all, you are worried about sexual predators.
Yeah, listen, it's not about me. It's about the women and men of America. And the poll numbers show us that the women of America in particular are very concerned about these allegations and in large part believe that they are a real issue. And
do you want to comment on whether the Clinton ticket has a relationship to a sexual predator?
We on the Kelly File have covered that story as well, sir. I will tell you the polls.
I want to hear you use the words. I want to hear your words. Bill Clinton, sexual predator. I dare you. Say Bill Clinton, sexual predator.
Mr. Speaker,
disbarred by the Arkansas bar. Disbarred by the Arkansas bar. $850,000 penalty.
Excuse me, sir. We on the Kelly File have covered the Clinton matter as well. We've hosted Kathleen Willey. We've covered the examples of him being accused as well, but he's not on the ticket. And the polls also show that
the
American public is less interested in the deeds of Hillary Clinton's husband than they are in the deeds of the man who asks us to make him president, Donald Trump. We're going to have to leave it at that, and you can take your anger issues and spend some time working on them, Mr. Speaker. Thanks for being here.
And you too.